Joe couldn't find his yellow schedule. But wait, a box? What could be in here? Kleenex? A shoe? Flowers? A ball? Carrots? But Thanksgiving's over. Mizzou, definitely not. Hey, a schedule! Now that we have our schedule, we can begin writing with pencil. Oh no! Oh no, what's happening? Oh, the frustration. Even ripping my schedule book. Now that our day is done, we can throw all our schedules away. But we should still take our day planner with us, just in case we need it. Oh, what's that? Could we be in violation of HIPAA? And therapist Joe is finishing up his day, but there's still so much to do. Perhaps some sticky notes would help.
I must ask you a question. Have you heard of the computer? It's a better way. Follow me.
Don't be a Joe, be a pro. Now Joe the pro will demonstrate electronic scheduling, the next wave in therapy office management. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is electronic scheduling. On your secondary screen, you can have the master schedule pulled up. On your primary screen, pull up Outlook. Open up the scheduling tool. And then make sure you're on the day of the master schedule that you would like. At which point, you can see if you have availability on your Outlook calendar that corresponds to the availability on the master schedule. If there is such availability, you simply type in the name on the Outlook calendar and type in your discipline on the master schedule. You can do this for several patients a day, as many patients as you would like. You can also expand a traditional 30-minute block of time to a 60-minute block of time by simply clicking the Outlook calendar appointment and dragging it down to make it 60 minutes. You also have a wonderful opportunity to generate reoccurring appointments. This saves pencil lead, broken pencils, and endless frustration of paper scheduling. Simply open up the Outlook calendar appointment, click on the revolving arrows, and set the repetition for your appointment. After you've done that, save and close the appointment, and you will see that that appointment has repeated itself 5 times. You can set it to as many times as you'd like it to repeat. In this particular case, it repeated over the weekend and into Monday and Tuesday because the original appointment was set on Friday. You can also print your schedule. You can print a weekly schedule so that you can lay on your desk and others may see it. You can also print a daily schedule that will be for your own reference. A daily schedule could be carried in your pocket. We wouldn't want to carry our whole day planner for an incredible violation chance of HIPAA. This is what it looks like. Clean, nice sheet of paper. Now, not only can you view your own schedule, but you can also view the schedules of others. And you can also check the schedules of others from the comfort of your own throne. You wouldn't want to have to walk all the way across our huge office to check somebody else's schedule. What if somebody's gone? Do you need to schedule somebody for them? Simply click their schedule and type in the name. Now, you can also, on the tasks bar on the right-hand side of the Outlook calendar option, set for yourself reminders, things that you need to do. Poor therapist Joe had plenty to do and no place to stick them. However, in Windows 7, we even have the option of sticky notes. No more sticky notes on your computer screen, all over your desk and on your person. Simply place a sticky note on your desktop. They're even available in blue and pink. We hope you have enjoyed this presentation and would consider electronic scheduling to save therapy nearly $1,000 every year. Thank you.
Did you say action?
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay. I am.
Stay recording.
Who else is coming?
I can still see Josh.
Yes.
Hark. All you gotta say is hark. Hockey
stick. What a dog. What a dog. He's a tramp, but they love him. Breaks a new heart every day. He's a